coming up on the Lowdown, Sony just announced when Hotline Miami is coming out to the PS4, and learn how they're making the already extremely violent indie game feel even more violent. Have you guys seen this year's World Yo-Yo Competition? This year's was the closest first place call in years. You can play Call of Duty Advanced Warfare a day early. Find out how. The Lowdown starts now. Hi everyone, I'm Elizabeth Panos with The Grid Gaming, bringing you the Lowdown. Sony just announced that Hotline Miami is coming to the PS4 this month on August 19th. Sony further revealed that this hyper-violent indie game will feel even more violent than ever with some DualShock 4 features. Gamers can actually shake their controller to perform execution moves, and the sounds of those executions are amplified through the DualShock 4 speaker itself. Square Enix made an interesting post on their blog this morning. They're currently working on a new episodic adventure game called Life is Strange with Don't Nod Entertainment. The backstory sounds really interesting, as the blog mentioned how things happen sometimes that you don't expect and how one tiny action can have catastrophic results. This entirely new IP is completely different from anything Square Enix has worked on before, and it's set to be released on the PS4, Xbox One, PS3, Xbox 360, and PC, but a release date has not yet been chosen. To check out the full story details, follow the link to the blog below. Titanfall's third map pack is being revealed this week. Respawn Entertainment will make the official announcement during Gamescom this week in Germany on Wednesday at 1 a.m. Pacific time. If you own the Titanfall $25 DLC pass, then you'll have access to the third pack in addition to the other two expansions containing new maps that were already released, Expedition and Frontier's Edge. If not, you can purchase individual expansions for $10 each. But what are you guys hoping to see in the new one? Did you guys get to check out this year's World Yo-Yo Contest? I really wish I had a yo-yo. I was gonna bring it with me and I forgot it. But this year's was the closest competition in years, with American Gentry Stein taking home first in the 1A freestyle competition. Stein was only 15, he came in third, but now Stein is the first American world champ since 2008 at just 18 years old. To check out Japan's Matsuura's amazing second place routine that only fell shy of first by 1.5 points, follow the link below. All right, Aaron's here, so what's going on, Aaron?
What's up, guys? It's Aaron Stapish, and welcome back. We are going to bring you guys a social hour real soon, but real first, I wanted to tell you guys something about one of the coolest tweets I've gotten in a long time, and it's from a guy named Steve Wesson. He said, at Grid Aaron, just finished my Jack animation project from The Nightmare Before Christmas. Worked hard on it. He gave me a link. I clicked on it. Oh my gosh, you guys, he did something super cool with Jack, kind of like a homemade project, and what you guys couldn't see from this video, you will be amazed. I was actually really shocked, and it almost did not look real to me. So to see that, you guys are going to have to stick around. Also, Super DD Super said, I want to eat Pikachu's brain. That's probably one of the best YouTube comments I've gotten in a while, so you guys are only getting smarter by the minute, but for some real smartness, because that's a real word, we're going to shoot back to Elizabeth right now. So Elizabeth, go ahead and take it.
EA just announced that its newly revealed subscription service we talked about not too long ago, it came out as a beta, but EA Access is now officially live on Xbox One. Xbox One owners can now download the app through the App Store and start using it immediately for $4.99 or subscribe for a full year for $30. Developer Knapknock Games revealed that the best way to make a video game sexually suggestive leading to a naughty time is to take a look at slumber party games. Well, if if you guys are still awake, Wii U's party game Spin the Bottle was released August 2013, where people take on challenges with a virtual bottle that aren't necessarily sexual, but that involve touching and trusting each other. Coors Guard from Knapnack said that developers should consider the subtext that players bring to the game, like in this Wii U party game. Okay, so real talk, do you guys like these kind of games? When I watch this, I literally put my head down on the desk. So do you guys like party games, or would you rather be playing some Mario Kart 8 on the Wii U? When you pre-order Call of Duty Advanced Warfare, you'll be able to play one day early with the Day Zero Edition.
Tsunami warning. Beware of changing tide. Tsunami warning. Please evacuate to higher ground. We're taking the lead.
After its multiplayer reveal event earlier today, Activision announced that Day Zero will be available starting on November 3rd on the Xbox One, Xbox 360, PS4, PS3, and PC, while the regular version will still be released the next day, November 4th. Day Zero players will also get two custom weapons, the Crossbow B2 and AK-12G Assault Rifle, in addition to the Advanced Arsenal bonuses. Anyone who pre-orders a digital version will also get the Day Zero bonuses and ability to play a day early. Thanks so much for joining me. I'm Elizabeth Panos with The Grid Gaming. I'm on Twitter and Instagram at Grid Elizabeth, and also on Facebook at Elizabeth Panos. And now Aaron's gonna take you guys away with Social Hour.
What's up, guys? It's Aaron Stapish, and welcome back to Social Hour, where I get to talk directly with you guys. Now, what I showed you guys a little bit earlier, I need to show you guys the rest of this. We need to take a look at this right now because this thing is amazing. Let's shoot to it right now.
What's this? What's this? There's color everywhere. What's this? There's white things in the air. What's this? I can't believe my eyes. I must be dreaming. Wake up, Jack. This isn't fair. What's this? What's this? What's this? There's something very wrong. What's this? There's people singing songs. What's this? The streets are lined with little creatures laughing. Everybody seems so happy. Have I possibly gone daffy? What is this? What's this?
I am not gonna lie, I was extremely, extremely impressed with this. What he did is he basically got like a little Tykes ball and he spray painted it and put like a projector against it, had the animations, downloaded the song, and put this all together with pipes. Truly amazed by that, and I tweeted you back, good job, and you said you actually met me at an event once, and I totally remember who you are. Nice playing an arcade machine with you and meeting your daughter, good guy. All right, next is to RWhiteB13. He said, Little Mermaid on the Nintendo is my guilty pleasure game. It's just one of those games that doesn't sound manly like Double Dragon or Mega Man. Dude, I am right there with you, and I'm not kidding. Little Mermaid on the NES is an amazing game. I actually reviewed the game before. Amazing, stellar Capcom game that shouldn't go overlooked, no matter what the name is. Krista Smith said, Xbox definitely has one of the most toxic gaming communities, with a little sad face, and she put, you couldn't pay me to play on Xbox Live. I'm sensing a PS4 fan. There's a lot of people rivalries with these PS4 and Xbox One stuff, so. Jason Newman says, Aaron and Elizabeth, you both are looking marvelous as usual. I know I am. Kind of. All right, next one. Chris, I got you, dude. I'm calling you out on this. A guy named Smashmaster, so I tweeted, send me a picture of what you're looking at, and he said, closes tab. So basically you're hiding what you're looking at. I know what you're looking at. You're a sick, sick man. Carlos Gutierrez says, besides humans, dolphins are the only other animal that has sex for fun instead of just reproduction purposes. All right, next one. Mighty Q Dog says, I didn't acquire a single game-related item over the weekend. I'm there with you, dude. That is hard to do. Like, people like us who collect video games, going anywhere on the weekend and not collecting anything related somewhat to gaming, whether it's cereal or an item, is hard. Next one, General Eastwood said, how the hell did you change clothes in 4 seconds? You're something else. He was talking to Elizabeth. She can change clothes and like that. My snap didn't even work. That's embarrassing. All right, Turlo Vizor says, I bought a bunch of Super Famicom games on eBay for less than 20 bucks. Good for you, that is good, I admire that. All right, next and the last one comes to us from Jason Equist. He says, Elizabeth's dope pink jacket has an old school Michael Jackson video fill. Sweet, ow! He didn't say ow, but I add that in. So that's really, I do like that jacket, Elizabeth. Good job on your style choice. But again, you guys, I'm Aaron Stapish, and I had fun talking to you guys. Make sure and talk to me soon. I'll talk to you guys again here soon at the Grid Gaming Network. See ya.